Welcome to Totus University. In this video, we will be interviewing an international student from Mines Paris PSL. Welcome.
Thank you.
Can you introduce yourself?
Of course. So my name is Ana Corrales. I'm 22 years old and I come from Madrid, Spain. And I've been doing for 3 years industrial and management engineering in the Polytechnic at Madrid. Here this year, I'm doing Erasmus exchange program. So because of the exchange, I'm doing civil engineering at Mines Paris.
So what made you choose this field of study and this school?
Well, actually, like, I had different options in my university for doing the Erasmus exchange. And I saw Paris, I saw Mines Paris, which is the second best school in all France for engineering. And I said, why not? And also the offer, like, why civil engineering and not industrial? It was like the thing they offered me. I didn't have an option, but I really loved it. So it was okay for me.
And how did you discover Mines Paris?
Like, they just told me it was this option. They were Mines Paris or at Arts et Métiers, and I chose Mines Paris.
So it was 3 years school?
Exactly, yeah. Like, they gave me a list of different cities, different countries, different options of university, and I just chose.
And so why did you choose to study in France over other countries?
I mean, actually, we're neighbors, so our culture is quite similar. I mean, I'm not very far from Spain. And also because I've always found France like a very, very valuable country, you know, very rich because of its culture, people, food, everything. So I said, why not? Let's discover France.
So what were your expectations about France before arriving?
Actually, I didn't have any much expectations because, I mean, I knew that it was going to come at the end of July and I came at the beginning of September. So I was just like excited, but a little bit frightened, of course. But that's it. I mean, I didn't overthink too much. So I didn't have that much expectations. Of course, they were high, but normal.
And how did you apply to Mines Paris PSL?
It was very easy, like, because my university, like, made me everything. They just sent me, like, a formula. I need to fulfill everything, upload a little bit of documents, and that's it.
What kind of documents?
Like, I needed to fulfill a learning agreement, which is a document in which you have to, like, write the subjects I would have done if I would have stayed in Spain, and the subjects I'm going to do here in France that are kind of the same. So that I had to fulfill, also, like, the passport, your identity, your level of French, everything, things like that.
Was there a language test to do for French or English?
I had to upload the document that I had the B1 DELF of French. But that was it.
So how would you describe the cycle of civil engineering overall?
I would say it was kind of complete because I did multiple things that made me realize that there are multiple fields in engineering and, like, I learned a lot from all of them.
So what were the most important or interesting subjects?
For me, the most interesting subject was the one about economy because, like, we analyzed what different factors influenced the oil industry for a company to invest or not in an oil company. It was very interesting because I did lots of things with data, with Python, and I learned a lot, yeah. But the rest was also very interesting. I mean, I found that I'm very happy of being an engineer because I love engineering and solving problems as an engineer.
Can you tell me other classes that you had?
I'll tell you, like, the three things I did. It was first a research about economy, then a project about intelligent and digital systems, and after a project in MECAERO, which is mechanics and aero. We finally made a drone, so it was quite cool.
Well, can you tell me more about the project with the drone?
Yeah, of course. Like, we divided it into different groups. Like, one had to make the drone itself, like the design, the way that the wings work and everything. Then, for example, me, I had to do the part of fabrication, which is like to print in 3D each part, to stick it together. And then we had to make it fly and everything. So we had to connect it with the motors and so on.
Can you describe a typical academic week that you had?
Yes, of course. So let's say it's different if you make a research or if you make the project. So if you make the research, it's like if you work, kind of like an internship, because you go every day from 9 to 5 and you go on and research and read a lot of things, analyze data and so on. And if you go to the project, it was more like 3 days a week when it was the practical part. And like I just woke up, go to university to 8:30 a.m., then have the break for eating. An hour and a half at 12 o'clock in the morning, very early, and then finish at 5. And it was also very nice because my university offered me courses of sports. So I did tennis this year because of my university. I also did a competition and all. So it was this on Tuesdays, for example. I had like break day for tennis, and that was during the project, of course.
So what do you think truly makes a difference in order to succeed in engineering in your cycle?
Okay, specifically in this cycle, if I think about the research, it's the mastery of the tools, because if I had known like Python the way my partners did, I would have succeeded the double. But of course, I succeeded it also because I learned a lot too. And then about the project, it's teamwork, no doubt, because like I learned a lot from my partners, and that was very important, like how to work with the rest, how to learn who's the leader, what to do, and manage and enjoy the project.
So how does the teaching style differs from Spain to France?
Well, as you could see, it's a complete different thing, because I'm used of studying theoretical things. Like I'm used of preparing, solving problems, but all in a paper. So I just arrived here and suddenly worked with embedded systems, with an Arduino, with fabrication things. So it was kind of a complete practical thing instead of the theoretical thing I made in Spain. But of course, because I did this part of the cycle engineering, civil engineering, because if I had started from the beginning here in France, you've got like 2 years of just theoretical and then 3 years of the practical thing in order to be an engineer. I learned that, and it was absolutely amazing to discover that I love practical things in engineering.
What were some key administrative steps that you needed to handle once you arrived?
I would say two. One of them is housing. Where should I live? I should live by myself. I should live with someone. I should live near or far away from my university. So then I talked to a friend of mine who had already been in Paris, and she told me of a girl's residence, which was like 15 minutes walk from the university. I also go by bicycle, which is amazing. But it was very hard, like, to look for a place and everything that had like to fit perfect with what I wanted. And then the second thing was like all the documentation, the administrative part, it was not that easy. So fulfill loads of documents for the scholarship, for the housing, for the loads of things you had to fulfill.
What type of scholarship did you apply for, or any financial aid?
Yeah, of course. I was very happy to receive two. One of them is the Erasmus scholarship, and the other one is the CAF, which is one of the French government gives me. But I'm still waiting for the CAF. I believe that I will receive the CAF.
So how did you manage the transition between Spain and France?
I would say that I'm a very flexible person, and also the cultures aren't that different. So, all right.
So were there any cultural or lifestyle adaptation that you needed to do?
Yeah, there were mainly two. One of them is the schedules. Like here in France, they eat super early, like at 12 o'clock. They have dinner at 7, 8 o'clock, when I normally eat much more later. And also, like, for example, boutiques and everything, they close at 6 p.m. And if you want to go to a museum, you at 6, everything is closed. And in Spain, everything usually closes later. So that was a change. And also, like, social life. Here in France, like, people, it's very open. Also in Paris, they're quite, like, used to the international people. But it's true that the real French, you have to precise dates, moments. So that was, like, kind of, wow, I really want to get to know you better, but I have to precise date and hour specifically.
Did you have to face any language barriers?
Yes. I didn't know any French at all before coming. I mean, I studied like 7 years ago a little bit when I was little, but it was nothing. So when I came, because I live in a girl's residence, I like forced myself not to talk in English, just to talk French. So it was very frustrating at the beginning because I really wanted to talk and to express myself. As you see, I'm very expressive, and I couldn't. So, but that was just like the first months, because then I get to know the French. I familiarized with the French, and it was a very good lesson.
Have you ever felt homesick?
Kind of, yeah. At the beginning, I was just going to stay in France for 6 months, but then I prolonged my stance because I was very happy. Yeah, so like in the first part, I was it was all very rushy, intensive, like I didn't stop. But in the second part, I kind of felt a little bit homesick, it's normal. But it's true that lots of friends came to see me, my family too. And I've also got like an aunt and an uncle that live here in Paris. So I've got 4 little cousins, which are great.
So how did you adapt to the student lifestyle in France?
It was all right. Actually, my university, Mines Paris, have a lot of things for the students, like to welcome us. We are called the ASTI, the people who come from outside, international. There are loads of events and things in the university. We did, for example, a week of skiing with the university, and it was absolutely amazing. So they organize that for the students. They've also have like on Wednesday afternoon, wine and cheese tasting. So you can go to university and with your partners, go and taste different wines and cheese every Wednesday afternoon. So that's a very good thing, like to make friends and all. And also about the schedule and all, it was very easy for me because usually in Spain, I spend the whole day in the university. So it was for me like a complete succeed to go out from university at 5. So it was all right.
So what are your next steps? What are you doing after this?
So after this, I'm going to make the master in industrial engineering in Madrid, in the Polytechnic. And this is 2 years master. So let's say that when I finished, I'll see. But what I'm sure it's that I love construction field. So I will do something that in relationship with that.
And after graduation, after when you have your diploma, what are you planning to do?
To work. And of course, I don't know if I'll work here in France or in Spain, or maybe I'll go to America, work a couple of years there and then come back. I don't know. I'm completely open.
So how has studying in France and more especially at Mines Paris PSL shaped your personal and professional goals?
So studying here made me realize that I love the head of an engineer. I love solving problems as an engineer. And also like more specifically in Mines Paris in Paris, like I had the opportunity of admire architecture and cultural places, which were amazing. And that really made me realize that I love construction, that I love this field, and I would like to realize professionally talking there. So it made me open my mind a lot in that. So let's say that Mines Paris offered me lots of tools through the subjects to discover that I love being an engineer.
Is there anything that you wished you knew before coming to France?
Yeah. There is an advice that my family gave me, especially my older sister, and it was, Ana, make sure to pass through the city, like to learn from Paris, but to learn from the people, from its culture, from its life, yeah, their way they think, they learn. And so I tried to make that, and I think that that made me success. So I would say like to the person that is coming to France, like be open, want to learn and try to pass through the city, like do not stay superficial.
If you could change or improve anything in your international student journey, what would it be?
It would be just learning a little bit more French before coming. But that's it. That's it. But the rest is part of the experience. So live it.
And lastly, what advice would you give to a student that dreams of studying in Mines Paris PSL?
I would say to the person that also be open and that be ready to work in teamworks and be ready to learn from the people, that you're going to learn a lot because you're going to be with masterpieces. Really, the people there, it's very, very intelligent. And enjoy, also enjoy, because Mines Paris, it's going to offer you loads of things and you just have to be open to embrace them.
Okay, thank you very much, Ana. And thank you for everyone that was watching the whole time. See you soon on Totish University. Bye.